In this video, I wanted to show you what a day in the life of a new wife is like. I did a video not that long ago about what a day in my life was like, but that was before I got married, before I moved into my new house. So I will leave the link in the description if you're interested in that. But this one's going to be what it's like now that I'm married. Austin and I have been married since March 12th to be specific of 2022. So it's hard to believe that we're coming up on a year. But I have kind of settled more into a routine now, and so I thought it might be just interesting to kind of share what a day in my life is like. This is a Monday currently when I'm filming this, and I wanted to film a weekday because we do just kind of various things on the weekends, and of course there's more weekdays than weekends, so I just thought it might be kind of cool to show you a weekday. So as you've already seen, I get up, I wash my face, and then I like to get my Bible or any other little devotional books that I want to read and come down here for some Bible and devotional time. I like to try to get up around 5:30. Like, we have the alarm set for 5:30, but I usually wake up before that, sometimes 5:20 after 5, 15 after 5, whatever. And I just like to try to get an early start because I really find that if I kind of do this morning routine, the day goes a lot better. So after this devotional time, I like to exercise and do some other things, which I'll show you, but this devotional time is the most important to me. So this morning, what I think I want to do is go back to Luke chapter 12, which is where I was studying yesterday, or maybe it was the day before. I like to kind of go back to things. It takes me a while to process and understand things. So I was reading in Luke chapter 12, reading that whole chapter, but I was specifically kind of reading what it says, the parable of the rich fool, where it's talking about the whole passage where it's saying, you know, consider the birds, consider the ravens, they don't sow, they don't reap, they don't have a storehouse. You know, it's kind of that whole passage, and I really like verse 25 and 26. Now, I've read this passage a lot, I've read it in the other Gospels, but I kind of got something different from it yesterday, and that's why I want to go back to it. I like verse 25, it says, and which of you with taking thought can add to his stature one cubit? And then verse 26 says, if ye then be not able to do that thing which is least, why take ye thought for the rest? I've read that a lot and I really like it, but then that really kind of started to make me think. I looked at it differently. I looked at verse 25 as almost like a call to action, like God telling me, Corey, don't be thinking about so many things that are in the future. Don't be thinking, I got to do this, I got to do that. What if this happens? What if that happens? Because he's saying, how can you add anything? You can't even basically add like a tiny bit of goodness or an ounce to your life if you're thinking like that. And then I love the next verse because it says, if you're not even able to do that thing which is least, if you can't even focus for like 1 second on the task at hand and not worry about the future, then why would you even worry about the rest? So if I can't even go through this day without worrying, why would I even worry about tomorrow? Why would I start thinking, oh, I got that appointment or I got this or that to do? And of course, it goes on to say, consider the lilies, how they grow. They toil not, they spin not, and yet I say unto you that Solomon in all his glory was not even arrayed like one of these. So then he's just saying, you know, he takes care of the lilies and how beautiful they are in the field, and even Solomon was not arrayed like one of those. So how could we be worried? And then, you know, it says that if God clothes the grass, which is today in the field and tomorrow in the oven, how much more will he clothe us? Doesn't he care for us if he takes care of the grass, which is today alive and tomorrow, you know, burned up by the sun? So I just really like this passage, you know, and it goes on saying, you know, don't worry about what you're going to eat or drink or have a doubtful mind. It's talking about, you know, the nations of the world seek after these things, and God knows we have need of them, but seek the kingdom of God, and all these things will be added unto you. And this was the verse right here that I looked up. I actually went in my concordance and was looking up the word fear or feel fearful in the back. And this is the verse that brought me here, which is Luke 12, verse 32. And it says, fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. I love that. It's so sweet. Fear not, little flock. And that's just a big comfort to me. Depending on what day it is, sometimes I just stretch, sometimes I'll pull up a video here on the TV and just do a little workout, but I try to do something because I notice that I feel a lot better if I do, and it makes a difference. So considering this is Monday morning and I'm filming this video this morning, I think I'm just gonna do some just kind of gentle stretching. Gotta work on touching my toes. So I decided I would lift just a little bit of weights. I like to do this kind of when I'm done stretching, just getting my arms worked out. So I've got some 8 pounds here. I like to just do a little bit of this.
Getting swole.
getting swole.
Getting jacked.
Getting jacked, Austin says. I don't know what you call this move where you send it down behind your head, but it's good.
Tricep dips? Or tricep extensions.
Right? Something like that.
Yeah.
So Austin usually gets up and goes straight for the coffee.
Oh yeah.
So you usually just sit and drink your coffee before work and...
Yeah.
You don't eat breakfast, do you?
Not much. I'll have something every now and then, but I don't eat breakfast much, no.
I have to eat breakfast. People are going to be either surprised or appalled at what a big breakfast I eat here in a minute.
Yeah. Well, for whatever reason, I'm just not overly hungry first thing when I wake up. I might, like, take a snack with me to work to have mid-morning or something like that, but... Most of the time, I don't eat a whole lot for breakfast. Man, I'm also not a morning person like Corey is, so I have to sit here with some coffee, wake up.
I'm very much a morning person. I can wake up at, 5 o'clock and just be wide awake, like, hey, what about this? And what about this? Are you ready to go?
Every morning is, I wake up and I'm not saying this in a bad way at all, but Corey just starts talking. And it's fine. It doesn't bother me, but... I don't say much back just because I'm not there yet.
Yeah. Come here, Olive. Hey, girl. Good morning. Good morning, little baby. So Olive gets up every morning and she's either really like ready to play and biting or she's just very sleepy. Yeah, usually she plays for a while and then gets sleepy again. You're so funny, Olive. Most of the time, Austin lets her out in the mornings if he's got time, because that helps me as I'm just trying to get ready and stuff. So my next thing in the mornings is that if I've got any time left, I will pull up my computer and just do some computer work, whether that's answering emails or YouTube comments or editing a video or even just at least touching base with the day. I've got my big calendar like right here that I use. Just kind of looking at the day, looking at what I need to accomplish, especially because if I kind of say, yep, this is what I'm going to do today, then throughout the day when I think, oh, I've got 100 things to do, I'm like, no, I don't. That's not true. I just go back to my little planner here and say, this is what I have to do today. I won't worry about everything else that I need to do tomorrow. And usually while I do this, Austin is typically still here because I might do this from like 6:40 to 7, so he might be here for 10 more minutes or so. And then when he leaves, I cook breakfast, so he's still just sitting in the chair over there. That is one nice thing about getting up in the morning. I am a morning person, so it's easy for me to get up. But then it's nice because we kind of get to spend some time together before work, even if we're not... like sitting and talking or anything, even if we're just kind of in the same room, it's nice that we get some time before we have to kind of be separated for work all day.
Come on.
Stretching your back legs, I see there.
Come on, pup.
Time to go out and potty.
Come on. Let's go.
Go on. All right, Austin's got to go.
Yes.
This is the point of the morning where I have to tell him bye. And it makes me sad because I miss him.
I don't miss you. I like going to work.
I love you.
I'm just kidding. That's a joke.
I know.
Love you, baby.
I love you, honey. I hope you have a good day.
You too. I'll see you this evening.
See you this evening.
This is weird.
After Austin is gone, I make breakfast. And like I said, I am going to make a... fairly large breakfast, I would say, for Monday morning, but I find that if I do not eat a big breakfast, I'm like crashing before lunch. So I'm going to make some eggs. I'm going to make some turkey bacon. I actually have some sweet potatoes I cooked. I'm going to have just a little piece of one of those for breakfast. I've got some fruit. So this should be a pretty good breakfast. We use olive oil mostly, so Just gonna go ahead and get those in there. Sometimes I sit here at the table to eat. Sometimes I actually sit at my desk or maybe on the couch, if I'm being honest. But today I just wanted to sit here at the table and eat. And it's nice in the morning. I'm so grateful that I have the time to cook a nice breakfast like this. And I've got plenty of time to eat it and just kind of sit here and relax before the day starts. And I like my fried eggs kind of runny. Not completely runny, but at least some runny, because if they're just completely cooked, I think they just taste too hard or something. I actually sent these to my mom and said, if you want to buy me something for Christmas, and I sent them to her like back in the summer. But I like them because if you've been on the channel, you know that Katie and I love the Golden Girls, and they had this set of glasses, and they would drink out of them. I guess they're from the 80s. Now it's time to clean up the kitchen before I go upstairs and get ready. I try really hard to keep the kitchen clean and really the rest of the house for that matter. Just keep it clean as I go throughout the week so it doesn't get kind of out of hand or get stressful midweek like, oh, the house is a mess. And I want it to be nice for me and Austin. And I want it, when he comes home from work, for the house to be nice and clean and for him not to be walking into a pigsty or myself. If there's any dishes in the dish drainer, which we didn't leave many in there last night, I'll always get those out first. And it's actually good for the pan because it seasons it and it leaves just a little bit of oil on the pan to condition it. So it's good. The last thing I do to clean up the kitchen is I want to spray the countertops just where the grease has got everywhere from cooking that turkey bacon and just try to keep it clean. As you can see, I'm just about empty. This is just an all-purpose cleaner bottle here that I used up. But this cleaner in it is some cleaner that I made. And that jar over there with the piece of chocolate on it is some more cleaner that I've got making. So it's ready to go into this bottle. I just haven't done that yet. But this is some really nice cleaner. It's just vinegar with some lemons and lavender. Vinegar is one of the best cleaners. It's just very safe. It's very cheap. And then you put those lemons and lavender in there. It gives it this pretty color and it smells so good. And you can feel really safe about cleaning your countertops and everything with it because it's just vinegar and lavender and lemon, and you could eat all those things. It's always nice having a clean kitchen when you come back. So when I come back to do supper tonight, it'll just be nice that it's already cleaned and I'm not having to try to fly in to clean it and cook supper. After I do the dishes, I like to make the bed. It's so nice to get into a bed in the evening and pull down the covers. I think that's so nice, so I always like to do that for me and Austin. Picking out my clothes for the day and just trying to make sure that I get some that are warm. These are some jeans that are fleece lined. Now, I mentioned these on the channel a good while back ago and said I wanted to get a pair. And I finally got a pair, but the funny thing about these is it took me a long time to get them. So we don't really live anywhere close to like major department stores, so there wasn't a place around here that I could get them, so I ordered them. And I made sure I ordered them from a place where I could send them back. Well, I had to order 3 times to get the right size. I got the size that I usually get, too small. Sent it back, got the next size up, too small. Sent it back, got the next size up. And they told me that these wouldn't be here until March. And I kind of laughed and thought, by that point, they're kind of pointless. But that's okay, I'll try have them for next year, or try again next year. But then they come a week or so ago. And these things are awesome. I can't believe that I have never had these before. I get cold really easy. Got a long sleeve shirt there. And then just a flannel that I got for Christmas that I've not worn yet. So that should keep me pretty warm. I've got socks, but I'm reluctant to lay them there because Olive will steal them if she sees them. Now I'll come in here and brush my teeth and finish getting ready. I don't really wear a ton of makeup. Sometimes I don't wear it at all. But the makeup that I like to wear is actually makeup that our grandma makes, and it's just mineral makeup. So it's never really seemed to bother my skin. And this is the only makeup that I've ever used. From the time I started wearing some makeup when I was maybe 13 or 14, she made it, and so this is the only stuff that I've ever used. And I know I probably don't put on my makeup like a lot of people do, so you'll have to excuse me, but I just do what I do and get done with it. I don't really enjoy spending tons of time doing it. Now, I don't really like to put on too much of it because I want to look like myself. I don't want to look like someone else. That's why I'm a big fan of the bandanas. If you've been on the channel before, you know I wear one of those a lot. And that's why I'm a fan, because I've never really been a girl who just fusses a lot over her hair and makeup because I'm just too lazy, if I'm being completely honest with you. So put my jewelry on before I leave. Of course, I got my wedding rings. Now, these little stud earrings are awesome. If you've been on the channel before, you know that I love hawks. Austin got these for me for Christmas, so I'm gonna wear one of them. And then these little earrings, Katie, my sister, made me a long time ago. And I want to say that these two little parts were earrings that I got at a thrift store. And then I said, hey, will you just add a bead? So she did, and I just love these little earrings. Had them for years. If you don't know, she does have an Etsy shop where she sells her jewelry that she makes. She makes some beautiful stuff, and I'll put the link in the description. Let me get my shoes on. These shoes Olive loves because they have this little thing there on the back, and I have to be careful. I've caught her with these shoes twice. These are the nicest shoes I own, my most favorite, and I don't want her to chew them up. Yeah, you like these shoes, girl? At this point, I go around, I cut off lights. I just kind of try to straighten things up a little bit so we're not coming home to a super messy house. I can get this lamp off there. So the first thing that's going in my backpack for the day is my laptop and my planner there. Then I'll make sure I've got treats for Olive. And at this point, she usually knows I'm leaving. And even though she's coming with me like she does every day, she usually starts to get kind of whiny. Yeah, I'm taking you with me. I wouldn't leave my baby. I can't leave my baby. If you've been on the channel before, you know that I work for my mom. And if you haven't seen that video that I made where I talked about what it's like working for her, I will leave the link in the description. But on Mondays and Tuesdays, I know since I work there, she can just come with me. So she's pretty much with me 24/7. She's hardly ever by herself. Yeah, little baby. Gonna fill up a water bottle for the day. Now, usually, this is where I would pack my lunch to take. However, last night I made a new recipe and I did not like it. So I'm hoping when I go to my mom's, maybe she'll have some leftovers or I can just make a grilled cheese for lunch, and I might try to make something tonight for lunch. The recipe that I made was like a chicken soup kind of recipe, and it called for fish sauce. Now, I know that sounds strange, but I got this recipe off the back of a rice noodle box. So I don't know if that's supposed to be like Thai food or Japanese food. I'm not really sure, to be honest, but I usually like that kind of food. And I put not even half the amount of fish sauce that the recipe called for, but I did not like it. It tasted, as you might imagine, like fish, which I love fish, but fish sauce is more like a fermented type thing. So I don't really have any lunch to pack. I'm gonna pack some snacks, and like I said, maybe I'll just be able to cook a grilled cheese at my parents'. That's actually a bag of prunes. I do actually like prunes, so I'm gonna take those. I got some dark chocolate. And then I've got a Cocomel. Cocomels are so good. If you don't know what those are, I'll put a link in the description. But they're basically like caramel, but they're coconut milk, so they're dairy-free if you can't do dairy. But I just love coconut, so they taste really good to me. I think this one is maple-flavored. Yeah. Here you go. Let's get it buckled on. Olive and I are in the car here. It's about 8:30 on Mondays and Tuesdays when I do help my mom. And like I said, I've got a whole video about what it's like working for her. So if you haven't seen that, I'll put the link in the description. But I like to try to leave by 8:30 to be there at 9. I usually help her till around 4. Then I'll come home and make supper. And you'll see that later on here in this video. But most of my days follow the same schedule, whether I'm over there or not. I just try to get up and then be ready by 8:30 to start the day. Of course, I do a lot of filming, a lot of editing, and that kind of thing. But I feel so blessed to just get to be self-employed and get to be a content creator here on YouTube. And I'm so glad that I have the time in the mornings to, you know, do my devotional and cook breakfast. And I'm so glad that I've got the time to cook me and Austin nice meals and keep the house clean for him and, you know, fold his clothes and put him in the closet because I love him so much and I want to do everything I can for him. So that's been, truthfully to me, kind of a really cool thing about kind of being a new wife. There's definitely been some kind of hard parts of trying to balance it all, and you know, it is kind of a full-time job having a house and cooking and laundry and dishes and cleaning and all the things that come along with being a homeowner. It's kind of been a lot, but I feel like I've settled into a just kind of a good routine, and I take pleasure in that. I take a lot of joy in being able to, you know, hang his clothes in the closet so he's got clean clothes for work and cook nice meals. And, you know, that really is a joy to me. And I've watched my mom do that for years. And I just think that that's something special. And I'm glad. I feel like being self-employed makes that easier for me to do. So I'm really glad for that. So Olive and I, we're going to head over to my parents' house. She loves riding in the car. She really does not mind, especially this same trip that she's used to, the same roads that we travel every day. She does not mind at all. She likes to look for deer and squirrels and anything like that that she sees. So we'll get going. I'm not going to show too much of kind of my work day because, like I said, I do have that video, but I will show just a little bit, and then I will show you kind of me and Austin's evening routine. It's pretty good. I haven't had a grilled cheese in years. It goes good with a little tomato. I used to make these all the time. It's just nice to have something that you can whip up really fast when you need to. So far today, we have got some cabbage and some peppers planted, and they're zipped up in here. I'm not going to unzip it because you can see good enough, but we got lots of peppers and cabbages. I'm trying to think. I think she said she had 32 cabbages planted and like maybe 20 peppers or something. So we've got a lot started in here, which is exciting. Lots of different varieties of pepper here, there on the bottom. And this is a really nice shelf because obviously it's got the lights, and then this zips so you can really just seal in the heat and the moisture, and that really helps the plants. We went ahead and sprayed them down with a spray bottle, and then because you do kind of want your plants to be resilient because they kind of get really tender in here, you can unzip this and just kind of let them be exposed to the air, and that will kind of help build up the resiliency for when they go in the ground. Olive is being lazy as usual. Just hanging out. Yeah, sweet little girl. She's not really bothered by the noise of the roof being fixed at all. She's just been hanging out. I just got back from the post office, and Mom and I are opening some packages. And look at these beautiful Christmas ornaments. A really nice lady named Linda sent these, and we are going to put these on our trees next year. And we would definitely treasure these forever. These are so beautiful. And we got another package. Katie and I got some packages. And there were some of these Christmas ornaments in there, which are really beautiful, and this really pretty lantern that I'm definitely going to put in my house. So we want to just say a big thank you to everyone who has sent us stuff. It really means a lot to us. Thank you. Olive! Honey! Olive, hey, hey, hey! You just want to play, baby. Olive gets very excited when we get home and she sees Austin. So a lot of the evenings before supper, Austin will shoot his bow. And he just recently got a new bow that he's really excited about. So that's what he's doing this evening. I'm going to go in a minute and just get out the leftovers and get them warmed up for us. Can we watch you shoot your bow?
You want to?
We'd love to.
I don't know how entertaining that'll be, but
it'd be great. Target's down there. It's hard to see the arrow, but
yeah.
It's so pretty in the evenings here because the sun sets over there and it's really pretty. Once it gets a little bit later, you can just look outside, especially from the top deck up there, and the sun just looks like it's on fire, which just sounds silly to say, but I just mean it's more orange than that. Another thing I do is I check Olive's bowls for food. She got some dry food there. Probably put a little more in there and then put some wet food for her just so she's got a lot to eat. Cornbread has already been warmed up, and so I'm gonna get our rice and stew beef going in the microwave.
Thank you, y'all.
You're welcome. Austin and I also recently found these, and these things are good. Like, this is better than regular ginger ale. Only problem is they're kind of expensive, so that's the bad part, but they're really good. Alright, it's time to sit down and take a load off and eat supper. I am pretty tired, and I'm going to be honest with you, most nights we just sit here and eat supper, and Austin sits in the chair where Olive currently is. Sometimes we eat at the table, but we just end up usually eating here, sitting at the couch, and we'll watch a show. I know that's probably not that great. We should be sitting at the table, and we'll probably get some comments saying you should be sitting at the table, not in front of the TV, but this is just what we do. And it's nice because this is just when we get to be together after we've had a long day. We've got some cornbread there. I have Olive behind me, of course. NCIS is good too. I'm fine with that.
Watch Jesse Stone later.
Yeah.
How about that?
Yeah, we've been watching the Jesse Stone series with Tom Selleck. I got that on DVD. I actually got it for like $17 off Amazon, and there's like 8 or 9 of them. It was on sale back at Black Friday. But Austin will have to get up to plug the DVD player up, and I don't want him to have to do that. So
we don't have enough
plugs in our house. Yeah, we don't. So we'll just watch NCIS instead. We love NCIS, so
mm-hmm.
We'll just watch that instead. All right, well, I'm going to turn this camera off so I can eat.
Want to do it?
We're in here cleaning up the kitchen, and then we both realized we could take this for lunch tomorrow and then just cook something else for supper.
Mm-hmm.
And naturally, I'm eating cookies after supper.
Mm-hmm. It's a good old lunch tomorrow.
After supper, we just try to clean everything up. So Austin's wiping the stove down.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, darling.
You're welcome.
We don't have many dishes. We just got a few and we'll get those done. It's just incredibly beautiful. At some point I would love to get the drone that me and Mom have and get it over here and fly up and kind of see those mountains better above the trees. But it's so pretty in the evenings when you come out and you can see that sun and those mountains look so blue. And it's just so peaceful out here. We're standing here trying to figure out what to do.
Yeah.
After supper, we usually have a couple hours before bed, and then we try to figure out what to do. Very often, I'll work on videos or emails or anything like that, and then I'll usually shower. Sometimes I'll read, crochet. Sometimes we'll sit back down and watch TV.
Yep. Just kind of depends.
Kind of depends.
Any number of things.
Yeah, sometimes you work out.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we wash clothes.
Yeah.
Just different things.
We have a working dryer.
Yeah, when our dryer works, we got it fixed. I mean, if you've been following the update videos, we got it fixed, and now it's messed up again.
Yeah, it worked for like 3 or 4 loads, but then it's squeaking worse than it was before now.
Ear piercing. So,
yeah, it's bad.
What do you want to do?
Come on. Might work out real quick.
Okay. I think while you work out, then I might just go ahead and shower.
Okay. Sounds like a plan.
All right. What you reading, though?
Called One Man's Wilderness.
Nice.
By this dude named Richard, I think his last name's pronounced Prinicky. And he lives in Alaska by himself in a cabin that he builds.
So, wow.
Yeah. And it's true. It's a real guy. So
nice.
Yeah. So pretty interesting so far. Barely started, but
cool.
Yeah.
Just for fun, just maybe a couple songs before I sit down on the couch for the evening. To the end. That is an Eagles song. Let's just be clear, I did not write that at all. That's an old Eagles song that I actually just discovered this week. We had a really great friend that we got to meet over the weekend, and he gave us so many CDs, which is awesome. My car has a 6-deck CD player that I love and use all the time, and I put this CD in and heard this song, and at the beginning of it, of course they're not playing it in this key, but the beginning of it starts like, you know, just as this solo guitar, and I'm like, oh, what is this? It really caught my eye, and I started listening to it and immediately just thought the tune and the way the voice was so beautiful. And then the longer I listened to it, I thought, yeah, Katie's let me hear this before. I remember this. So started working on it, and it's been really fun, and it's a cool song. This is the book that I've been reading. It's pretty good. I found this at a thrift store pretty recently. And it's a sweet little book. It's kind of about two sisters and how their lives are different and how they kind of come back together. It's the first book by her that I've read, but I definitely would like to read another one. Pretzel dog.
Pretzel dog, yes.
All right, baby.
Old Olive does not like going out at night.
Nope. She always has to go out one more time before bed, and she does not like it.
And I always have to carry her out because she's so lazy.
Oh, poor baby.
Get the white off of me, Mom.
Poor baby.
It's embarrassing.
Poor baby.
You're embarrassing. Making fun of me and all fun of all my friends.
Good night, Olive.
You going to bed? Is that what's happening? Is that what's happening?
Is it bedtime, girl?
You little dork.
Good night.
Come on.
Good night, sweetie.
Come on.
All right, sorry the lighting in here sucks, but I'm not going to get a studio light. I'm too tired for this. So this is what a day in the life of being a new wife is like. This is just kind of what my days are like now. It does kind of depend on what day it is, but for the most part, the weekdays are the same. I only help my mom on Monday and Tuesday, but it's kind of the same type of routine, and that's pretty much what I've got going on. So blessed to have my sweet Austin. I love you so much.
No, you don't.
You're my best friend, and so blessed to have this house and have our sweet little pup. And
that's right.
We are very blessed.
We are. We're very, very lucky.
We are. It's only like 20 till 9, but I go to bed early, y'all.
She does.
Usually I'll come in here and I'll usually be asleep before Austin's even showered, and he'll shower and then come to bed. But I'm tired, so we're going to end this video here. Yeah. Drop a comment and let me know what you think. Let me know if your routine is anything similar like mine. As always, thank you for watching. God bless you, and we'll see you on the next video.